We might come across a situation when you have to decide which PLC suits best with the HMI, or which IIoT device would be best for the application, or maybe how to link these devices all together, what are the cables or protocols to be used. If your answer is yes, this video is for you. Let's keep them aside and let me introduce you PLC Next Technology from Phoenix Contact. This is not just a standard PLC, it is a controller which is capable of meeting the current challenges of IIoT scenario. Let me open it quickly and show you. This PLC trainer has everything which you need to proceed towards IIoT. This is PLC Next Control, the open controller for limitless automation. This is designed by Phoenix Contact to provide one-stop solution for industrial Internet of Things. This controller supports OPC UA, MQTT, Profinet connections, cloud connectivity, and has a Linux operating system inside, which means there is a possibility to use a lot of IIoT apps which you can find in the PLC Next Door. So let's see what do we get with this trainer. You get an Ethernet cable which can be used to connect this PLC with a computer or internet. We get an adapter to power up the PLC with 24 volts. So let's quickly give the power. Here we go, the PLC trainer is powered up. Power is distributed to the digital and analog I/O modules connected to it. You can connect any power source of 24 volts. Now let's connect the Ethernet cable at one of the ports. The another end of Ethernet cable goes to my computer. Along with this trainer, we get a Profinet cloud credit which can be used to get cloud services. There's a startup guide to get to know about this trainer. It's available in English and German. Here is the power switch. That's the PLC module where we plug the Ethernet cable. That's the digital I/O module with some LEDs which shows the status of inputs and outputs. Right next to it, we have analog input and output module. That's the potentiometer which is connected to analog input module. Here we have some toggle switches for actuating digital inputs. If I actuate the switch, it gives 24 volts to the digital input module, and you can see the LED status on the digital I/O module. And this is giving 0 to 10 volt to analog input. Here we have a slot to insert the memory card. At the moment, there is a memory card inside with 8 GB capacity. So that was a quick introduction to the hardware. In the next video, we will see how to program this PLC using PLC Next Engineer software. And you will see how to read-write digital input and outputs. You will see how to read-write analog input and outputs, how to design HMI screen and visualize it over the web server, how to actuate OPC UA and interface it with UA Expert, how to interface Node-RED with PLC Next, how to interface Factory I/O with PLC Next via OPC UA. This is not all, more videos are coming in which you will see how to install the apps in the PLC Next Linux environment. So stay tuned and subscribe to this channel for more updates. Thank you for watching this. I will see you in the next video.